Hello friends, I'm here with a new video for you. As I promised in the last one, this is for regular hexagon, super magical hexagon. So in this video we'll see how we can calculate all the identities using this single hexagon without remembering the identities, right? So let's see how. I have made a hexagon for you. So this is a hexagon, super magical hexagon. So how it is made? It is being made by just naming the vertices by the trigonometric functions. Six trigonometric functions we have: sin x, cos x, cot x, cosec x, secant x and tan x. So we have just named the vertices, and in this order only then we will be able to find the identities. Right, so let's see how these identities can be taken out. So I have written all the basic identities. So the first one is tan x into cos x is equal to sin x. So if you'll see this hexagon, we'll see the first identity as tan x is equal to tan x into cos x is equal to sin x. So that is, just if we jump over a single trigonometric function, you will get the middle trigonometric function. That is, if you multiply tan x into cos x, that is jump over a function, you will get the same from the middle function. So tan x into cos x is equal to sin x. Similarly, the next vertex, if you'll see, sin x into cot x is equal to cos x. That is, just jump over the function. So next is cos x into cosec x is equal to cot x. So jumping over the function, you'll get the middle function. This is the first identity. Second one is tan x into cot x is equal to 1. So if you'll see this, tan x into cot x is equal to 1. So over this diagonal, if you'll see, you have tan x into cot x. Again, jumping over the diagonal this time, you'll get the middle 1. So tan x into cot x equal to 1. Similarly, sin x into cosec x is equal to 1. And similarly, secant x into cos x is equal to 1. This is over the diagonal. That was over the boundary, right? Now, third one is tan x equal to sin x upon cos x. So this is, if you see along the boundary without jumping, you'll see tan x is equal to sin x upon cos x. Similarly, sin x is equal to cos x upon cot x. Similarly, cot x is equal to cosec x upon sec x. And similarly, it will go on like this over the boundary. So you'll get the third one along the boundary. Fourth one says secant x is equal to cosecant 90 minus x. So if you'll see the adjacent trigonometric ratios, this is secant x is equal to cosecant 90 minus x. Similarly, tan x is equal to cot 90 minus x and sin x is equal to cos 90 minus x. That is over this line, parallel lines. You will get this identity in these parallel lines. Fifth one says sin x into cosec x equal to 1, or the division identity, it is sin x equal to 1 upon cosec x. So if you'll see along the diagonal, sin x is equal to 1 upon cosec x. Similarly, tan x is equal to 1 upon cot x. Similarly, cos x is equal to 1 upon secant x. So over the diagonal, we'll get this. First two was jumping identities. This first one was jumping over the boundary. Second one was jumping over the diagonal. And this is along the diagonal, right? The last one, which is very important, is sin square x plus cos square x is equal to 1. So if we'll see this identity, we have to see the triangle. So if you'll see the yellow triangle, you just need to start from very left and you have to move in a clockwise direction. You will get this identity, squaring all the terms. So you'll get sin square x plus cos square x is equal to 1, right? Similarly, if you'll see the pink triangle, starting from very left, it is 1. So 1 square plus cot square is equal to cosec square. And similarly, the third one, tan square from very left in clockwise direction. So it is tan square x plus 1 square is equal to secant square x. So all the three trigonometric ratios, identities, you'll get from these three triangles. And other subsidiary ones you'll get from replacing the, changing the positions, like you'll get sine square x is equal to 1 minus cos square s by just taking this cos square x to the other side. And similarly, this can be taken, cos square x can be taken over that side. So it will 1 is equal to cos x square x minus cot square x. Similarly, 1 is equal to tan square x minus secant square x. So all the other identities are derived from this basic identity by just changing the positions. So you can have the other identities as well. So this was all in this hexagon. You can take out these basic identities and you can apply this without remembering any of them. So it is a very, very helpful hexagon. So keep watching, keep liking, and keep subscribing the videos. Thank you so much.